Okay, so let me first of all, what you need to write, I write a measure, okay, for you. So that, okay, I can write some of the logics, okay. So, what do you want to keep it? And whatever it calculate. Sum of sales already. Sales. Yep, okay, and then filter is I want to have two filters. Okay, both the filters need to be a work. Okay, so region equal to was that region equal to is. Region equal to test. So here I do have like two things that I need to like maintain. Here we don't get the answers. Okay. We should look how. What? Okay, where is it? And get some data. Why we are getting this? Can you tell me? Can you tell me like this? Here by default it is taking end, okay, because what order cells will be either east or west. Order cells may be either east or west. Okay, the orders which are there in the east will not be in the others west, right? So that is the reason it gives that. In that scenario, we don't like, okay, we don't write. This is not like example for end. It is to show like yeah, I'll show you some other example rather than this one. Like you can feel something like. Year off. Order date. Let's make the order date directly. I'll take the order date. Where is the order date? Order date. Year of order date equal to 2020. Okay, that is what you needed right now. So 609 is my answer, but I want to look at it okay for okay. Equal to month around the account text loan around the material. So obviously make it like Pakistan chuta answer was the purpose of the getting the same, right? Or else is there any changing? Yeah. You can see 97. Okay. Plus, so right now it is taking this one and this one. Okay, is this taking like this? So I'm not okay. A and D. So by default, okay, when you give, okay, two values, okay, two combinations, okay, by default, okay, when you give two combinations, okay, so it will take, okay, end operation. Both the things need to operate, okay. Both, okay, sales year should be like 2020 and then like month should be like 12. This is the answer that we need to get. The same thing, I'll write it in a different way and then you can understand how, what is the difference between. Whenever you write, okay, or like normally it will take it as end. So let's make it like an or. See the sales difference between here, what it is taking. It is taking means it is taking, earlier it was take in the particular end of end thing. You can see here both year and then like month, okay, it used to like calculate, okay. Both the things need to be like true. It should be, the year should be like 2020 and the month should be like, okay, to, like 12. Means, okay, in the month of December in 2020, what is the sales that is giving here. Then whenever it is R, okay, so obviously what it is giving, so either the total sales over here in the 2020 and or okay, the total sales in 12th month. Means 12th month total sales means it might be like any year. So that one. So the in that case, okay, it is showing the sales. So all the total sales of 2020 plus all the sales of like okay, 12th month. Maybe it is any year it might be. That is these two things it is calculating and then adding and then giving the answer. So this is the scenario. When you use to R, when you use to N, you need to understand. When both the need things need to be true, then only you want to get the answer means you'll go for the end. Either may be true, this one may be true, this one may be true, but okay, anytime we need to get answer means, okay, we use this kind of thing. This is the difference between end and R. By default, if you write two things, means it will take it as end. Okay. When we do have some logics, will be like end or combination of end and or, we'll write multiple end and ors. So obviously we need to like at that instant, we need to like remember where to write branches need, how to keep those things. Because in that relation will be in such a way that end or, like this kind of relationship will be there. You'll get it, these kind of things. So then obviously you need to keep this end. And then we do have like double end kind of things also to keep it like end. But most probably this kind of end is used. End, first value and second value, whatever it might be. Okay, got it?
Yes.
Okay, and then false, okay, is like whenever the logic is false, okay, we want to check whether the logic is false or not, okay, we'll go with this one. Okay, this kind of things that we'll learn later, okay, I'll tell you like, okay, what is this false and true. Okay, whenever the logic is true, just go for that. Else, okay, this one. So in the if condition, we'll write it. You know if how to write it. Logic, true value, and false value, write it. I'll tell you like, okay, or something else. Like, okay. This value. If n is more than like, okay, 96,000, then obviously so, something else that you can write it. Take some value measure or whatever it might be. I want to take, okay, end value, end measure which have been created right now. So end measure value is greater than, okay, 96,000. Then obviously show me something like, okay, yes, or else no. In the logic. If we, okay. You'll see the value is like, okay, more than this. So obviously we'll get answer. Okay, if I make it like 98, so what will I get? We'll get no, because this value is not more than this one. So based upon that, you can write anything. And somewhat, okay, if you, whenever this condition is true, then this will be activated. And then whenever this condition is false, then this will be happened. And then you can check it out what you'll write. I want to write that one directly. So what I'll get? Always I'll get yes only. Simple. It means always the logic is true. So obviously we'll get yes. If you write false, okay, over here, always this no will be shown over here. So not just for here, okay, we will write this kind of things, okay, a lot of times. Okay. So, and then we have some other things like switch also. I'll just tell you that one also. SWITCH. We do have switch. Okay, let's make it like SWITCH switch. Then switch true. What need to be true is that there should be something that you need to write. You return, you give true. What should be true? End measure is okay. End measure is okay. Greater than okay 9600. Okay, then what I need to show my result is greater. That is what I want to show. Okay, or else, comma, you can write it. What we can write it, okay. Not greater. Okay, you can write it. Not greater. You can dump it. So when true means whenever this logic is true, so it will show us this one. Or else we do have in the true, we do have like S is part, this part and that part. I'll show you like comma. So you can see. First one is expression, second one is value. If the value is based upon this expression, okay, based upon this value, you will find this result. Or else this result. If any of this result is not followed, then obviously you'll get this answer. Okay, so how you can show this? Okay, so then in switch also, like we can use it like even red colors also, red, or else we can make it like a okay, green. I want to make this color, okay, is less than 96,000, like okay, then I want to give it red, or else again I'll write it the same thing, Control C, and then like I want to make it like Control V here. Again, comma is less than 97,000. Okay, I want to make it green. If it is okay, or else I'll make it like greater than. Okay, you can write it like this also. Or else, if it is not like between less than or this thing, okay, I'll make it like 98. Okay, greater than 98. And then okay, I want to make it else. B-L-U-E. What will be the my answer right now? What will be my answer, Sarah? What will be my answer? Sarah. Are you there, Sarah?
Yes.
What will be my answer?
Only greater than less than 96,000. What is the value of 1?
97. You get blue because okay, if the value is. Okay, if the value is less than 96,000, if and is less than 96,000, if this is true, we'll show grand, or else if this is true, we'll show green. If both the things are not accepted, like okay, not true, then obviously it will go for else value, so that will be shown. So you can write n number of conditions over here. Not only the thing, okay, if the selected value is like, you can write it like some other things also. What we write it as, we've been learned regarding selected value, right?
If it is applied to a font color, it will change to color, sir.
Yeah, you can just simply use that one, okay, to here, and then like, okay, it will show that one. Simply use that one, measure. Then this is a card, even card also. You can,
yeah, yeah.
Here, FX is there. You can use directly from here. You know that? Okay, how to use this?
Yes. I have done it.
Effects, and then go to like, okay, fixed value, field value, and then go for, okay, whatever. Orders table, and then like, you'll have like switch. Okay, the measure name, and then like, the see?
Yes,
sir. And then see here, okay, the same function, I'll write it in another way. Okay, so. Slicer, want to make it like slicer, and then the same, like I'm showing you the advanced kind of things. It's basically if we tell okay one thing and then people will go move to some other function, but I want to make it something more. Selected value, okay, of particular, okay, region. Where is my region? Region. So if the reason is like, okay, I don't need to give the reason because here, okay. Central, CENTRAL, central like, okay, then okay, if it is not central, okay, if it is east, 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 okay. So like that, I mean, if it is okay, I want to make it like south, S-O-U-T-H, south, and then like comma, orange, O-R-A-N-G, orange. Okay. Afterwards, I'll write comma, and then whether we have written everything right or not, okay, let me check that one. Okay, what we are getting right now, blue. So if I select something, then based upon that, it will change. You can see. Understood what I've been taken?
Yes, yes.
Selected value of this particular, okay, region means what we selected, based upon that, it will give. If selected value means if the selected value is, if this selected value is central, then it is red. If it is east, green. If it is south, okay, that's for you, TH south, sorry. South orange, or else it is, if it is not all the three, then obviously for the west, okay, it will give blue. We don't need to write that one. You can make it in the else part, okay? So if you go for east, what we'll get? Get it in the green, right? Go for south, get in the orange, go for west. So blue, and then what we do, if we can click, okay? If you click 2 also, we'll get okay, blue only, because that is in the else part. Got the logic? If you have any doubt? Any doubt?
Show me the measure, please. Switch syntax, according to switch syntax. According to switch syntax.
What is it?
Switch syntax is the first expression, right? First expression.
Yes.
Selected values is an expression. And the central is a value. Okay. Okay, clear.
Okay. So in this way, like basic function will be the same. Remember, going advanced means writing something else based upon that. Okay, something need to be changed. Okay, these things you will find it only while you practice a lot. You will get okay, understand like what I can do here. Every time we used to do this. Okay, what expression means, that can be anything. So in that way, you will get more logics and then you can implement. Just remember, okay, whatever we have been learned till today, each and every thing will be used like in some other different scenarios. A lot of scenarios. Based upon that, we can tweak it. Tweaking knowledge, if you need it, means okay, you will be become expert. But for that, okay, practice daily 10 hours practice is also not enough. People tweak that. People tweaking means okay, we'll do something from that, okay, like these kind of things. Not only this, okay, they'll convert like normal visuals to some other visuals, something like they'll do. Like you can't even see that okay, visual, and then you can't understand like what's happening over here, how these are changing. You can't even even imagine the logics only until you see, and then like not only once, okay, you need to see a lot of times, then only you'll understand what they're written. So that is called a tweaking kind of thing. Existing, they don't write any something new. They write the normal functions only. They don't use like difficult functions. But okay, using them in such a way, the answer will give like okay, fantastic. Okay, we'll go fix something else. And then true, not okay. Whenever it is not means okay, if it is not a logic, if it is not in this particular case, you can write it even here also. The one which has been written over here. Not selective value. So if it is central, then obviously it will look whenever you want to like make it something like completely opposite. Whenever it is not something like okay, again, like we been created like art. Not this thing, this thing. So whenever you want to make it the reverse, then obviously. Whenever not means if it is not 2020, then also you will get the answer. Got it? I don't want to get okay only for okay 2020. I need to get all other things. You know what you do? Not year 2020.
So not 2020 and month 12. Not month 12.
Obviously, you can make it for okay both not and not okay for. So it's like just like okay, when if you want it, you'll make that logic. Okay, order date is equal to 2020. If you don't want that one, then obviously you make it not year 2020. That's it.
Okay.
That logic won't work. Okay. Only that particular thing, it won't work. Okay. For only 2020, it won't give you. Rest all things, it will give you. And then you can write it directly from here also. Like if you can maybe make it less than or greater than, it is not simple. Okay. If you keep, okay, not simple. And then you can make it like ampersand, just like not this here. Here.
We cannot give two arguments. Only one argument.
Huh? Between two arguments, you can give the double end means and okay, then like this double pipe means okay, R, and then like this one is like okay, not.
Okay.
Like that. Okay.
Not of then,
this one. These are symbols like okay, double end is like end, double pipe is like
this
one. Double less than or greater than is this one. That's okay. Like, okay. Not but if error means okay, we don't use very rarely. Like whenever the value is error, then obviously we get that one. That's not a thing. Switch and the true. Then we do have like a good function over here. Go with that. For that, I want to create something like when you want to like create average, minimum, max, all these things. I'll just give you a small brief of that. Average sales, I want to find that one. So obviously, average sales. Simple. Average of sales. The total sales, it will take the average. Average is equal to AVRAGE, average of sales. What would be the average? get the average cell. This is the average cell. Then what is the minimum cell? Obviously, in that only I'll write it. What is the minimum cell? Minimum cell will be obviously, I hope, zero. Minimum. Okay. The answer. Minimum is 0.99. So what is the maximum? This is the maximum cell that has been done. And then like you can make it like count rows also. Count, distant count of, okay. And then like subcategories also you can write it, okay. Count of C-O-U-N-T, count of, okay, subcategories. Like I want to make it like categories. Categories of it. There are like 4, 8, like 2, 4. Okay, I'll tell you like why. And then just copy this and write it like controls. I'll make it another measure. We do have like distinct count. Okay, again category, and then like make it particular category. What do I want to take? What would be the answer? We'll get 3. Means okay, these 3, like we do have like furnitures and then technology and then other thing kind of things. Okay, 3 categories. Okay, if we find distinct means, okay, we'll get that particular distinct categories. But okay, if you find how many different, like whether it might be repeated or not, okay, like how many categories are there? Like, okay, if you want to check this, you can see this particular count. And then like sometimes if you want like count, okay, the entire table, how many rows are there into the entire table? Maybe this might be different. Sometimes we'll have like blanks and that at that particular time, okay, we'll have like errors. Maybe in this particular rows, if we have blanks, okay, we don't get a total number of rows over here. So obviously I want to create another measure to create count rows. Count rows can be done on a table. So I'll just check it out. Why it is taking too much of time? C-O-U-N-T-R-O-W-S equal to count rows. C-O-U-N-T count. Count rows, sorry. Count rows. Now that we need to give table. It will take only table. So I'll give it orders. Orders table and then it will give you the answer. Oh. These are counters. Here you can see both things are same because we don't have any blanks over here. We do have all the things. Okay, so obviously both the things will be the same. The distant count and the count and this one is like same. So that is the thing. And then like what we do have other things that we need to learn. Minimum, max, distant count, count, and then count blanks. Whenever we do have like blank values, lot of values. How many cells are blanks? Okay, that we can use it using count blanks. Okay, count blanks in that, okay, we'll give the column name, then it will tell us how many blank values are there available in that particular column. Okay, and then we do have rank x. That is very important and then, like, very interesting kind of thing. For that, I'll create a measure, which is the total cells for our users. Just for our users. And then I'll create a new measure, simple. And then what is my scenario? And after that, I want to create some rank. Okay, so what is my rank and then how I want to show that? Okay, so I want to take comma. And after that, I want to show this something like a subcategory. I want to take it and then I want to take total sales. So based upon total sales, I want to give ranking based upon subcategories. So what is the top first subcategory that was got highest sales? Based upon the sales, okay, I want to get ranking of the subcategory. So we can do that. Okay, we have a function called rank X. It will go row by row by row by row by row and then give the ranks. Make it sure it will go row by row by row and then it will give the ranks. Rank X, it is an iterative function. Remember, it is an iterative function. So based upon that only it will work. Rank X, okay, and then by console right tab, then we can see table expression value order and price. Okay, value we need to take or not, okay, that is something else, and then but okay, we need to take all the other things. Orders is my table, okay, so comma, and then expression is my total sales, okay, and then value is not necessary instance, and then order ascending or descending. I want to make it like descended from top to bottom. And dice means dense and skip. You know, like what is dense and skip? Do you know that?
No.
What is skip and what is dense?
No.
Okay, let me tell you, like, whenever we do have these things, you'll get it in like SQL. Dense and skip will, your values will come in SQL.
Yeah, dense rank, but skip, I don't know.
Both the things, okay. Dense is skippy, we do have like on the same SQL only we'll have. Dense means, okay, like let us suppose that I do have like same values for second and like, okay, I do have like two people who are same like in second rank. So what the skip will give, 1, 2, 2, and 4 it will give. It won't give you like third rank, but dense will give you 1, 2, 2, and then it starts from 3. So that is the dense, okay. I want to make it like dense, okay. That's it, and then close it. So we'll get error. Why we are getting error? That you need to tell. Try to do that. Where is my rank? Okay. We're getting 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Why are we getting? It's an iterative function. So what it will do? It will go for every row. And then check, okay, what is the sales? And then like, okay, what is the rank of that particular category? So when it goes to like this row, so obviously how many rows are available in this row? Only one row is available, right? This current context will work upon this particular like iterative function.
Okay.
So obviously for this particular X series of kind of thing, we do have sales, and then that is only one row. So obviously it will get one. Then again, it will go. It doesn't checks for all these things. It will go for each and every row, and then it will feel like, okay, only this for this value, like current context, you know, like current context. Every time we discuss the current context. So in that way, it will go into that particular okay subcategory and then feel like that is the only one available. So obviously it will give work there. So right now, this current context filter is applying on this particular table, and then like, okay, that is why we are getting this. So to remove this current context or to remove this, okay, what we can do, whatever the filters that are applied over here, what we can do? We can make it all. So all yep. The very, very basic logic.
Yes.
Filters, okay, any current context or whatever it might be is applied, okay, that will be removed. Very simple. Okay, why we are not getting exact right now? Again. So why? Why? This is the perfect. So have you been observed, okay, or earlier, okay, all selected? Observe. So even like subcategory, everything it is going to take delete. So what we need to do, we need to take, okay, only this thing, current context removed from this thing. So obviously what we'll do, all selected. For this selected category, it will remove and then like push. Simple logics. Like when you like go through this filters, when you go through the filters, okay, obviously you can understand what exactly all selected, okay. To remove the current context kind with one single column, okay, we'll mostly use this all selected. Simple. But when we use all, okay, obviously all other things also will apply on that. Okay, maybe we don't have anything, but okay, what it will take, okay, not even okay, subcategories, things, okay, category kind of things, okay, these will be like, okay, apply. So we don't go with all those things. Maybe we are not applying any filter, but like, obviously it will like consider some of them. So that is why in the ranks we'll use all selected simply to remove this current context. Simply to remove the current context, we use all selected. Just remember like that. Very simple thing. So obviously, whenever you have like descending to ascending, that you can use this. So what if I have like category and subcategory? Based upon that, I need to. First of all, again, you can see 3, 3, we're getting there multiple times because it is not understanding like which one to take. Okay, so again, category is there in this, like, okay, particular thing, we are getting 3, and then like appliances, you are getting 3. In technology, again, it is calculating like this, it is going to calculate, so it is meshing up. So, other category which came out into this particular thing is meshing up. So, what we can do in that scenario, what we can do. We can make it cross join. This is an interview question. Interview question, just keep in mind. Cross join, and then like again, what we can do, we need to take two things. All selected. All selected of what we, okay. All selected. Then again, in that particular thing, what we need to write? Category, I need to write it. And okay, I need to close the passage. Is that thing right? Cross join off all selected, not selected. Did we write anything wrong? Cross join off all selected. Okay, here we need to write it. Yeah, then it will be right. Okay, let's see. See, you're getting the ranks. Perfect. So this is how it happens. Remember, okay, these two things, okay, people ask, like, whenever when you have like multiple things, then how we can do, make use of cross join. Simple one answer. If you don't tell, okay, that will be like very basic thing. If you tell, that will be like very experienced kind of thing. So remember this thing. Okay. Rank is used in a lot of things. Whenever you need to like compare with the values also, we use rank. Okay. Rank used in different kind of scenarios.
So the rank is for which one?
Which one it means? Cross join of this, both category and subcategory it is taking, like, okay, fully for, okay, you mean like, okay, which kind of like for this are right, you are asking, right?
Yes.
It is taking for this one, like, okay, based upon this and this, but it is taking for this.
Okay.
And then like not only here, okay, only to get the ranks, okay, whenever we want to like make even top three we have, like, but some other scenarios we'll use rank X to find like cumulative sales. When, okay, whenever it is no date kind of thing, we want like running turtles or simulated turtles which is like used by turtle sales kind of things, but we don't want to use turtle sales. But when we want to find the cumulative find up changes, we'll use this kind of. Not only this, rank X, like they want like top three kind of things or something else. They want filter. Even though we use rank X, but sometimes we use top and top three, top four, but sometimes we'll use rank X. That depends upon the scenario. When it comes, means that depends upon this. Okay. And then index also by very useful. Index also very useful. We feel like that is very useless, but okay. Based upon index also, we can do a lot of things. Index is that thing, but okay, it's like a row number, right?
Yeah, give me a row number.
We can make it like from the zero, from the one, okay, we can make it, start it. Again, we'll get it until the rows exist. So obviously we can make it like that. So we can use it as a row number, and then like we can calculate like which one, whenever the index is like 10 means whenever the row number is 10. Right? Say same thing, right?
We can give it in the measure itself, but not showing
That is not a measure kind of thing. That is not a measure kind of thing. It is like a column kind of thing. It can be given in measure. You can use that in a variable in a measure, but you can't make it output as a variable. You can use that
variable. It gives output is column only.
If you use the variable, means that is for instance that creates an instance table inside the variable. Variable means it does not exist anywhere. It will be just created in the memory. You can't see that variable. You can't see that. But okay, based upon that thing, you can create or calculate something else, and then you can show that a scalar value.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Okay.
That's it for today. And then we'll have some real-time scenarios kind of things tomorrow, which is visual customization kind of concepts. Interesting, but a bit complex. Those are advanced things. If you practice all these things completely, then only you can understand. Until then, you can't understand them.
Yes.
Remember, okay, that those kind of things that we are going to discuss tomorrow, completely advanced. If you are able to do that kind of short, you are habituated to, never feel like okay, you will get visual customization kind of concept, as regular or kind of like copy kind of things. Or once I've been done these things, if I get no, you never get these kind of things. Visual customization, obviously, every time that is new. You need to understand the logic. You need to check about the data, what we do have, and then you need to plan accordingly how you want to show that. That is entirely different concept. When you are more curious, when they are more like design oriented, when you are like more logical oriented, when you can tweak anything by seeing just data, you can tweak anything like from here to here. You can use a lot of functions from here to here. That thing happens. Otherwise, that is completely messy kind of thing. So you decide whether to go with that or not. If you want me to, I'll definitely tell that. But whether you want to, my suggestion is just practice all the scenarios, all the things that we've been discussed a lot of time, lot of times. And then you can get the logics. The one which we discuss tomorrow. I'm not trying to threaten you.
Can I share my